Our friend and colleague, TVNZ presenter Greg Boyd, has died suddenly. The 48-year-old One News Tonight presenter was holidaying with his family in Switzerland. He had a distinguished career in television and radio and has been a familiar face on New Zealand screens for more than 20 years. His family released a statement describing him as a treasured son, husband and father to two children. The head of TVNZ News and Current Affairs said Boyd was a wonderful man and a talented broadcaster who strongly believed in the power and importance of journalism. Boyd had suffered depression. Police are monitoring social media for threats of retaliation after a... And that is One News at midday. The team will be back at 6 this evening. But before we go, we want to acknowledge our friend and One News colleague, Greg Boyd. Our thoughts are with his family, his friends and loved ones. Our newsroom won't be the same. Moi mai rā e te hoa. Rest in peace, my friend.
Fundraising contributions.
Kua wahangu te pū kōrero. An outstanding communicator has been silenced. It's been a hard day here for the One News family, and it's with sadness and heavy hearts that we mourn the sudden death of our friend and colleague, Greg Boyd.
Kia ora, good evening. It's been 6 weeks of nappies, feeding and barely leaving the house. Now the Prime Minister...
He's talking about Jacinda Ardern there, obviously, but from the 6pm news to Fair Go, Close Up, 7 Sharp, Q&A and most recently One News Tonight, Greg had a varied and distinguished 21-year career across many TVNZ News and Current Affairs programs. He'd previously worked in radio and print media. The 48-year-old died while holidaying in Switzerland with his wife and youngest child. His family say he was the kindest and most caring man, a devoted father who cherished and loved his two children. Greg had been battling depression. He'll be dearly missed by his whānau and all his workmates here at TVNZ. We'll remember Greg for so much, his warmth, his kindness, his wit, those quick one-liners, those brilliant riposts, but also for his love of music.
Was somebody who can play it fantastic with me, pile of crap.
You go, guitar man. Make some sweet music up there. Thank you for being the most generous, wittiest and most talented person all in one package I've had the privilege of knowing. Our thoughts and prayers go out to your family. Kia kaha. E te hoa, moi mai rā. Rest in peace, dear friend.
Yes, a great friend. You'll be greatly missed by us all. There's been lots of tears in the newsroom today. And now I will try and move on to the next news story.
The Pacific showers from Vanuatu to Tonga. Looking pretty good, though, for the other islands. That is your weather. Sunnier days on the horizon.
Thank you, Chris. Thanks, Chris. And that is One News for Wednesday. A sad day here for one from the One News team. We'll hand you over to 7 Sharp now. Good night.
Thank you so much, Wendy, Simon and Chris. And hello to everybody. Thanks so much for joining us. Well, as you can imagine, it's been a terribly sad day here at TVNZ after the sudden death of our friend and colleague, Greg Boyd. He was not only a gifted broadcaster, but a much-loved dad, husband and son.
We know that many of you will have had days like this too, losing someone dear to depression. And we share those feelings of sadness over Greg with you because you knew him too. Welcoming him into your homes as a reporter and presenter across many shows here at TVNZ, including this one. Tonight, as we send our thoughts to Greg's family and friends, we want to mark his 21 years at TVNZ as the consummate professional, talented reporter and great wit that he was.
Just a quick note on this story. Greg loved music, so the backing track has got some of his favourites.
Good evening. As we go to air tonight, the United States still does not have a new president.
Greg Boyd was in his early 20s when he first joined TVNZ. A fresh face with a golden voice and a gift for storytelling.
The former Mr. Whippy's down cones, claiming their hours were too long and their pay too low.
The campaign by its disgruntled trio of ex-employees has hurt business. In the last month, David Dixon estimates custom has dropped by around 50%.
He believed in good journalism and the power of it.
I'm joined by the Prime Minister now. Good morning.
Good morning, Greg.
What happened?
Look, I haven't the slightest idea.
Is Gordon about?
No, sorry, he's not.
Whereabouts would I find Gordon?
I'm not sure, mate.
So we went to his house, hoping to get some answers to the mess, and Bill, ABC Plumbing, left at the Kohanga.
Hello, is Gordon in?
It's in confidence they asked me to keep it.
But as you can accept, Tane Randall, for one, has come out very strongly saying by naming no one, you're effectively putting all the people in that era who were in the All Blacks under some degree of suspicion.
Yeah, and I guess if he says, you know, it's gutless, I'd rather have that than betray a confidence.
As far as other players go, I mean, did you see anyone actually taking steroids, or these two players that just came to you and said, look, we're taking them?
That's all they said.
Really?
Well, you're not the one with the suitcase handle up the bum. That's why you're feeling excellent.
But behind the serious newsman, we all knew a much cheekier side.
We got most of the urine out of the pool.
And over the years, viewers got a glimpse of that too.
Retractable seatbelt. What's retracting going on there? And here's the biggest now retracted.
Well, you are a bit of a bogan.
Yeah, I am a bogan, but most of the things I don't drive have a great big bucket on the front of them. They just got mag wheels, man.
I said I'd buy you a drink afterwards. Hang on.
We all appreciated that humour, even the Prime Minister, who remembered Greg today as a thoughtful interviewer who was quick to share a laugh. And all day in the TVNZ newsroom, three words resounded. A man of kindness, generosity and fun.
That'll be a win!
As one colleague put it, it's so sad such a wonderful person spent so much time in the dark, yet lit up the world of those around him.
I can't get it, but I couldn't resist. But I'm a realist.
With somebody who can play it fantastic with me, part of crap.
Greg, my friend, you were anything but.
And if you or someone you know needs help, then you might like to take a moment and just write down some of these numbers. We will also put all of those details on our Facebook page.
So tonight, we want to run stories that we reckon Greg would have liked. Stories about interesting people doing pretty amazing things. And this next one certainly fits the bill.
Nicole Bremner, One News.
As you may know, it's been a hard day here for the One News family. It's with sadness and heavy hearts we share the sudden death of friend and colleague Greg Boyd.
Kia ora, good evening. It's been 6 weeks of nappies, feeding and barely leaving the house. Now the Prime Minister...
From the 6pm news to Fair Go, Close Up, 7 Sharp, Q&A and most recently... This was his show, One News Tonight. Greg had a 21-year career across many TVNZ news and current affairs programs. The 48-year-old died while holidaying in Switzerland with his wife and youngest child. His family say he was the kindest and most caring man, a devoted father who cherished and loved his two children. Greg had been battling depression. He'll be dearly missed by his whānau and all of us here at TVNZ. Coming up after the break, the Nazi next door, a death camp guard, is deported from his New York home. Where will he face justice? Plus, it's been touted as a game changer for migraines, a breakthrough treatment that can stop the pain before it hits. Right, let's take a quick look at tomorrow's weather.
On a simple line, day by day, the earth spins on its axis. One man struggles while another relaxes. There's a hole in my soul like a cavity. Seems like the world is held together just by gravity. The wheel keeps turning, the sky's rearranging. Look, my son, the weather is changing.
I've been dreading this part a little. You would have heard the news today that Al Gregg died suddenly in Switzerland. He was the host of this show for a very long time. Gregg was kind, warm, funny, a lover of music, old V-dub Beatles, journalism, and of course, his family. We will miss him. Ka nui te araha, kia koe e te hoa, moi mai rā. So much love to you, dear friend. Rest in peace.
Kia ora, good evening. Denied a venue yet again.
Hang on, I've got to be a man about this, right? Ready? Okay, half man about this. We got most of the urine out of the pool.
High five.
High five.
You look like you're enjoying yourself there. What the hell are you going for?
Take note, New Zealand. Now I'm going to walk and I'm going to talk. You watch me do that. Didn't even fall over.
Pleasure. Yeah, nice to meet you. Thank you very much.
Hello, it's Gordon then. Can we speak to Gordon, please?
The most rural thing about me at the moment is this shirt, this country road.
Oh, I couldn't have scripted a better finish, Gregg.
There are a heap of videos on YouTube of you sort of taking the mickey out of yourself.
You have to laugh at your life. I do, you know, have bad days and low self-esteem issues just like everybody else.
You are a king. You lead a king's lifestyle.
Doubtful a black London cab is the mode of transport for many other Tongans. The king, though, says that is all about practicality.
Quite simply, a London taxi has the right proportions, makes it easy for you to get in and out of whilst wearing spurs and a sword. I realise that these criteria are not everyday consideration for the ordinary mum and dad when they come to buy in a family car. You know, may I have one that allow me to get in and out of with wearing my sword and spurs?
Spur clearance. I'm the king.
You